That brings us to our final award tonight, the Illinois PGA Professional of the Year. The Golf Professional of the Year Award is another award that is truly voted on by fellow PGA members. It is the highest award that can be bestowed on a PGA member. If I can direct your attention to the video screen and ask you to join me in a very special presentation that tells you more about our 2014 honoree.
I love the game. It's a game that you just can't beat. It's the only game you can't win.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain.
His warmth, his sincereness, his smile. He's just a genuine guy.
He's one of those people that's really warm and embraces you, especially if you love to play the game.
His smile, his inflection in his voice, when he emphasizes things, those are two of his great, great character traits.
Big smile, his patented, his laughter that he has. It's just like a big bear hug that you get just from his voice and his being.
The story of my life, I take her home. I drive all night to keep her warm in time. It's frozen.
Freshman year of high school. There was this young fella sat behind me and he tapped me on the shoulder, our first class in freshman year, and he said, "What do you want to do?" And I said, "I want to be a golf professional."
This club has gone through so many stages over his, 25 years as the head pro and 29 years overall. You just can't say enough what he has done for the growth and the health of this club.
Without a doubt, Jimmy had a nice experience here as an assistant pro. He engaged the members, they engaged him, he had an opportunity to come back. He did a lot of good for the game and the golfers here over the years.
The first time I took a lesson, and when I was nervous, he had me calm. But lessons thereafter, he got to really know me, I got to know him. It's a good feeling knowing that I can, if I have a problem, I can go to Jimmy and say, "Jimmy, fix me." And he does.
The story of my life, I'll take her home.
Very rare today to see people stay in a job, in a position, for as many years as Jimmy Holmes has with Ravinia Green Country Club.
Jim, I think, has been here for 29 years. You don't stay at a place that long unless you're doing a good job.
It says a tremendous amount, not only Jimmy, but Donna, working side by side through all of these years together and keeping it fresh. I think that's terrific.
If there was ever such a thing as a yin and a yang, and you want that described, it's Jim and Donna. Their lives intersect in a way, and they have features and qualities which just complement each other.
She's very, very good at what she does, and she certainly was a great compliment to him. And they're a pretty good team, pretty impressive.
We're just like best friends, No matter how busy he is all day long at work, and we kind of do our own thing and running here and there, and every single day, we always stop and have lunch together. He really cares about the guys that work for him, and as I do, it means a lot to him to look at them and think that maybe he helped them in some small way get to where they are, those that have gone on and gotten some great jobs, and he's very proud of them. He's just a real, real sweetheart, and I hope he knows I love him very much.
Donna is not only the best mother, best partner, companion, love. I'd never be here without her.
The story of my life, I give her all. I spend her love until she's broke inside. The story of my life. The story of my life.
I made a lot of great friends good relationships, and it's been a privilege to be here for 29 years.
It's pretty neat to be able to know what you want to do at an early age and be able to fulfill your dream.
And the story goes on.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Illinois PGA Professional of the Year, Jim Holmes.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you, Casey. As many of the award recipients before me, feels like I'm being interrogated here. Before me, realize that this is the first time they get to see this video is sitting here tonight alongside you. And it's truly overwhelming. Thank you, Mike and Bill and Jared, one of my favorite ones that we're going to miss so much. Lauren, Kathy, Mark, and Nick. It is no small undertaking. I was just overwhelmed with their professionalism. They came to the club, to give you an idea, they came to the club about, I let them in at about 5:45 in the morning. They worked all day hard, as you could see, with the interviews and everything else, and they were still filming at 6:30 at night when I left. It's truly amazing, truly amazing. So what you do for the Illinois PGA is way above and beyond anything, and I can honestly say that I think I can speak for everyone saying that we appreciate what you do throughout the year for the Illinois section. I'd love to give these guys a great round of applause. Dick Wagley, Mark Labiak, thank you so much for thinking of enough of me to nominate me, and for your friendship throughout the years. One of the things that's I truly appreciate about our great profession is the camaraderie amongst all the fellow professionals. We are, in a sense, a great fraternity, and we share in a dream together, participating in golf tournaments, working together, and also being there for one another through good times and bad. It's great to see so many of you here this evening. Thank you to the awards committee for the vote of confidence in recognizing me with this honor as the 60th recipient to receive this award. It is humbling to have my name alongside so many of the past award winners, and I am equally honored to be included with the fellow professionals that are being recognized this evening, and congratulate all of you. By looking at most of them, I thought maybe you had to have hair to get an award. When you put a lot of hard work, as all of you do, into your profession, and you're recognized for it, it's really a good feeling. And I can tell you there's no greater honor than be nominated and selected by your peers. As you saw in the video, I grew up in a small town in Michigan, and we moved to Park Ridge, Illinois, when I was a freshman in high school. As fate would have it,
There was a country club right down the street from my new home. And so it was, I would land my first job at Park Ridge Country Club, picking up balls on the range. I was 13. And then I would go on to work in the bag room, and as a starter, and then finally as an assistant pro. All in all, I would spend 8 years at Park Ridge Country Club under the tutelage of Ken Weiler. I attribute Ken in laying the groundwork for how I would forever conduct myself as a professional. Ken, you see, believed everything less than perfection was unacceptable and ran a very tight operation. He was thorough in his preparation and took great pride in his tournament operations. Westmoreland Country Club under Vern Fraser would be my next opportunity in the golf business. Vern was years ahead of his time in terms of pro shop merchandising. He was most fairly likely the first pro to take advantage of resources such as the Merchandise Mart. Then it was on to Ravinia Green as the first assistant for Pete Mazzetta. Pete was the consummate teacher, and the hours I spent with him on the practice tee honing my teaching skills were invaluable. Sadly, all three of my mentors have passed on, but each in their own way were visionaries in the golf profession, and I owe so much to each of them for giving me the tools to succeed. I would go on to become a head professional for 6 years at Highland Park Country Club before returning to Ravinia Green for what would be the remaining 29 years of my career. Between my years as an assistant, then as the head pro, I have spent over half my life, and I can truly say it has been an honor to be able to serve the membership at Ravinia Green. Over the years, the members as well as the staff always treated us as family, and I thank them for that. The fact that I was able to spend the majority of my career at Ravinia Green Country Club was truly the icing on the cake. I really appreciate the members that are here to share this evening with me. Bobby Fink, former vice president, and his wife Debbie. Rob Fisher, former president, and his wife Marlene. Jeff and Nancy Glass, Bobby and Kathy Lipke, Rick London, our club president, and finally Andy and Flory Perellis, all of whom are much more than members. They are very good friends. And I am I would be remiss in not to mention how fortunate I am to have my wife's parents here with us tonight, Bud and Carol. I love you both. As head professional, you realize that you would not be able, you'd be unable to do the job without the support of a great staff, as many of you said this evening. I would like to thank all my assistants that have worked for me through the years, many of whom are now head professionals. I could have never done it without all their help. My two assistants from this year are here this evening, Randy Fershaw and Rob Drogos. You guys have done a great job, and I appreciate all the hard work that you have done, and I know you'll go on to do great things. Other former assistants are here this evening, including Brett Packey as a young man who was recognized this evening for a tremendous contribution to the game of golf. I personally congratulate you on receiving this honor. Mentoring assistants and working with them to become the best that they can be has always been very important to me. And if at times I've been a little tough, hopefully you and those before you can take away from it that you learned a lot from the experience. I think it's also important that I thank many sales reps that we have had the pleasure to work with over the years. In particular, I'd like to thank TaylorMade for the years that I've been able to serve on the national advisory staff. Joe Morris, Chris O'Brien, and before him, Len Berg. You have all gone above and beyond taking care of my account so that I can in turn take care of my membership. We all know that during the golf season, the hours are long, as also many has mentioned today, and we are used to the 80-hour work weeks. It's tough on the family. I could have never done it and would not be standing here tonight if for not for one person, and that would be my wife, Donna. She is my best friend, my partner, the love of my life. As many of you know, Donna and I have worked together side by side for a total of 35 years, and I would not have had it any other way. And together we have raised two beautiful children that are here with me this evening, Jennifer and Jeffrey. We are so very proud of you. I wish I could see you. And we love you both so much. As you are aware, I am about to retire from Ravinia Green. I've had a tremendous run, and there's no regrets. As I've said many times, I've never really looked at it as work. In the last few months, many of the members have approached me with their stories. How does one put into words what you feel when someone comes and relates how they took their first golf lesson from you 25 years ago, and that you were the one who inspired them to love the game? Or a member who is ready to quit the game, and until you help them out with their game, and they are so appreciative. Knowing how you have impacted people in the way that they too love the game the way you do. Isn't that what it's all about? I will miss it, but change can be good, and I'm excited to see what the next chapter of my life holds for me. In closing, I think Derek Jeter captured so well what I'm feeling at this moment when he said at the conclusion of his last game, "Thank you, because this is all I've ever wanted to do, and not too many people have the opportunity to do that. It is above and beyond anything I dreamed. I don't know what to say. I've lived a dream since I was 6 or 7, and now the dream is over." What a great way to go out. Thank you very much.